Welcome back, guys. We're continuing this Grand Tactician Civil War Confederates Max Difficulty No Infantry campaign. And we've got a pretty even fight on our hands. We've got a clear advantage in guns. They've got a little bit of an advantage in manpower. Only slightly, though. So it should be an interesting fight. Hopefully we're going to be on a different map, because we're not, we've retreated a little bit, so it's difficult to tell where the new maps are in each area. It would be nice, a nice quality of life to be able to see that. So we are on a different map. Oh, that's not very nice. I'm the one who's meant to be defending. I'm sitting still defending. And yet I'm the one who has to attack. And that is not a nice place to attack. Right in the middle of a bloody forest. The hell type of position is that to attack? Right, well, really, I want my cannons along here, but don't think they're going to do much for me. They've got a point down here. That's not healthy. Right. Well, I can't see anybody. Got another point up here as well. Well, I think I might test out the scouts on the cavalry, seeing as I don't really know how they work. I think now would be a good time to test it out. I mean, having my artillery here would be nice, but that's only if they come towards me. So I reckon it's going to be very difficult to utilize our artillery advantage. So, going across there is probably going to be the way forward. So, let's get everyone set up along this road here. I think I'm just going to leave him here. And then he's going to go do some scouting. Okay. So let's deploy the scouts and then issue a movement order, see what happens. Okay. That's interesting. Don't know how helpful that will be. Yeah, I'm really not sure what benefit I get from that. Let's send him on a long journey. And just see what happens when he encounters somebody, if he encounters somebody. Okay, so we've spotted some people here, and they are heading in that direction. So let's see what happens. Well, he looks like he has stopped. Think he stopped. And then, doesn't let us retreat. So from there, we can recall the scouts. So yeah, I suppose it's a way to prevent running into enemies with your he's moving forward now though, so once you recall the scouts, he carries on moving. So you'd need to send a halt order. Okay, fair enough. So annoying how sometimes you can retreat and other times you can't. Well, that didn't work. The detachment was meant to go in front, not the bloody cavalry. Why is it not letting me retreat? Well, it was worth a try anyway, I wanted to test it out. Well, apparently, he's received his order. And he hasn't moved. So that's not good. Letting me retreat now. I wonder if that's because the HQ is within range. So it only lets you retreat if the HQ is within range. It's quite possible. Right, well, let's start bringing everybody up. This is the only road up to there. I'm going to be risky, move the entire army. Well, that's a long line. Right, obviously they could redeploy anywhere. So let's see. I think that's probably the best position. Okay, let's see where they redeploy. He did not redeploy, he stayed where he was. Interesting. Apparently, I can't shoot through these trees here. Well, let's see what happens if we deploy scouts. Did it deploy them? Yeah, so the scouts are deployed. So now let's move up. Oh dear, I don't, I'm struggling to see the benefit of using scouts. I want to see if I issue an attack order, if the scouts get in the way of the division. Right, let's bring him up. Yeah, this is probably a terrible idea. But I just want to do it for science. Probably not a good time to be testing new mechanics out. So yeah, it looks like the scouts get in the way and the division themselves don't actually get into range to shoot. Not, he's definitely getting into range to shoot. Or at least he's very close to it. Yeah, I'm not seeing the benefit of scouts. getting in the way, preventing me from firing. Yeah, he's preventing me from firing. I don't understand the benefit of scouts at all. Oh well, it was worth a go. I had to know. Right, let's bring everyone back. Well, the one benefit of scouts is they don't use ammunition. So it's like having free ammunition, but you can't control them without controlling the main force. So I'm not seeing it. Not seeing it at all. This guy just does not want to retreat. Well, I wanted to test it. I've tested it. It's not that great. Gonna have real trouble here, not being able to use the cannons. I do not know what the best situation is here. I can't decide what I want to do. Right, okay. These have just stopped moving. Come on. Don't want to do that. That's what I want to do. There we go. What is this? I don't know what this line is here. I'm going to issue a halt order. Hopefully that'll fix all this weirdness. Right, let's see if we can get these cannons doing something. That's not the right one. Right, I'm going to bring the cavalry over on the flank. Right, let's bring him over here. This isn't ideal. Oh, he's still moving. That's good. It looks like they're moving out a little bit. They're moving back in again now. What is he doing? There must have been a better route than that. Dear. Not ideal. The cannons aren't shooting. It might be because the cavalry are in front, but it's more than likely because of the trees. So let's just bring the cavalry in for an attack. on earth are these cannons doing? You're heading the wrong way. Oh my goodness. What are you doing? Oh my god. Right, well, the cannons are going to be useless anyway, because I'm fighting in the trees, so I suppose I could just basically ignore them. Ah, they seem to be coming towards me. So let's tell everybody to turn and face. Interesting. They're all coming out. Right, that's the right-hand side. That's the left-hand side. Let's get the left-hand side. Ah, that's so frustrating. Hate that glitch. I think I might be better off just turning these cannons and firing. They're going to take forever to get into position. Let's just tell everybody to attack. Yeah, unfortunately I've got the glitch where I can't issue orders. Oh, it's actually working now. That's good. this has not been an ideal battle at all, but we are going to get the victory. But the odds are definitely not the type of odds that I like. See the damage. Almost 9,000 losses. Painful. $9,000 to $1,500, so 1.5 practically. Not the type of ratio that I like to get. But it was an awkward battle in the trees. I was probably lucky that they came out of the trees, to be fair. Otherwise it could have been a lot worse. Thank you. Right, well, I think we should call it a day for this episode. So cheers for watching. Take care, and I'll see you soon.